Welcome to everyone. This is Dr. B. Manimeglai working with Dr. H. J. Thiruvengadam and Dr. N. B. Balamurugan of Thyagarajar College of Engineering, Madurai. Our presentation focuses on radiation from antenna and different types of antenna. This picture shows various wireless communication systems such as hydroelectric power plant, substation, wireless relay station, microwave link, satellite base station, substation, communication with the car, etc. Here we can say that antenna plays an important role. We can define an antenna as a vital component in any communication system which is used at both transmitting end and receiving end. Antenna is basically a conversion device and made up of a long conductor. Antenna at the transmitting end converts electrical energy into electromagnetic waves and radiates into free space. At the receiving end, it receives electromagnetic waves and transforms into electrical signal. An antenna is an efficient interface between circuits and the outside world. To have proper radiation, antenna impedance should match with the feeding circuit. Antenna should be able to direct the energy in desired direction. With widespread use of various technologies, there are new challenges in antenna engineering. This picture shows the evolution of antenna. Before 1960s, we had tower antennas and radios were used to receive the signal. During 1970s to 1980s, again tower antennas were used, but at the receiver side, transistors antennas were used to receive the signal. During 1980s to 1990s, mobile communication evolved and we had a very compact system for transmitting and receiving the signal. Considering the evolution of antennas, you can see that there happens a reduction in size of the antenna and hence the wireless system. Now we are in the era of millimeter waves. This picture shows that how the electromagnetic radiation happens. The voltage across the two wire transmission line creates electromagnetic wave between the conductors. The created electromagnetic field travels from the transmission line to the antenna structure. The electromagnetic fields become self-connected loops and become independent of antenna structure. To create radiation, there must be a time-varying current or acceleration or deceleration of charges. That means di by dt should not be equal to zero. This yields moving charges induces electric magnetic field. Time-varying magnetic field induces electric field. This is well proved by Maxwell's equation. Dou E by dou t tends to give dou H by dou t, which in turn gives rise to dou E by dou t. So in order to have a radiation, there must be either time-varying field or acceleration of charges should be there. This slide shows various forms of transmission line meant for radiation. They may be curved transmission line, bent transmission line, discontinuities, terminated or truncated transmission line. This picture shows the animated form of electromagnetic field coming out of a small dipole present here. This picture shows that how the transmission line, within transmission line, the electromagnetic fields are set up and how it is propagating towards free space via the antenna. So we can define the antenna is an open-ended transmission line. Even this transmission line can be bent to 90 degree and that is what we call it as a dipole. The region outside an antenna is subdivided into three regions depending on the distance from it. The amplitude and phase distributions of radiated field are different in the three regions. These are reactive field, near field and far field. In general, emission of electromagnetic energy from an antenna results in complex fields having both real and imaginary parts. Next, we will see about the types of antenna. These are the basic platforms of antenna such as wire antenna, aperture antenna, array antenna, microstrip antenna and lens antenna. The wire antennas could be dipole, loop antenna and helix antenna. The aperture antenna has a physical aperture through which the waves flow. The examples include cone, slot and reflector. The lens antennas are not commercially used for the applications because of its huge weight. Microstrip antennas are the printed form of antennas which may take either rectangular shape or circular shape. Not only antenna acting independently, they can be grouped together to form an array. This array could be either passive array such as IQ antenna, or it may be a array of printed structure. Nowadays it's called as phased array system. Thank you.